trusted in thee are. We are humble until Lege Domini. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto. Sicur erat in principio et nunc et semper. Et in saecula saecula.
Reading of the Epistle to the Ephesians. Brethren, see how you walk circumspectly, not as unwise, but as wise, redeeming the time, because the days are evil. Wherefore, become not unwise, but understanding what is the will of God. And be not drunk with wine, wherein is luxury, but be ye filled with the Holy Ghost, speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual canticles, singing and making melody in your hearts to the Lord, giving thanks always for all things in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, to God and the Father, being subject one to another in the fear of Christ. Continuation of the Holy Gospel according to St. John. At a time, there was a certain ruler whose son was sick at Capernaum. He, having heard that Jesus was come to Judea into Galilee, went to him and prayed him to come down and heal his son, for he was at the point of death. Jesus therefore said to him, "Unless you see signs and wonders, you believe not." The ruler said to him, "Lord, come down before my son die." Jesus said to him, "Go thy way, thy son liveth." The man believed the word which Jesus said to him and went his way. And as he was going down, his servants met him, and they brought word, saying that his son lived. He has therefore of them the hour wherein he grew better. And they say to him, "Yesterday, at the seventh hour, the fever left him." The father therefore knew that it was at the same hour that Jesus said to him, "Thy son liveth," and himself believed, and his whole house. You can sit. Sorry, today there is quite a lot of announcements. Some people, they joke because sometimes announcements are longer than the sermon. Just after this Mass, we'll have the exorcism of Leo the 13th. We have that every first Sunday in October. Regarding another announcement, very important I do now, because it's again a very big disorder in this church. The first one is try to arrive on time. You will never, never dare this tardiness in your business, in your worldly business. And this is the first point. It's Sunday, you come for the Lord, and the minimum respect is to arrive on time. I understand that some are coming from very far. They have excuse. Some, they have many children. They have their excuse. But many have no excuse at all, and it's more than half of this congregation for this Mass. When I entered for Asperges, there were less than 50% than we have now in this church. It's a problem, and you have to think about it. You come for the Lord, it's Sunday, and you don't come late. And some are coming very late. The second point is about the bathroom. It's terrible to have to tell that from the pulpit. This is the time of the Lord, the Mass, and it's not the time to go to the bathroom. And dear parents, you have to discipline severely your children. I'm sorry. You have a full day, and there is a time for Mass. The time for Mass is not a time to go to the bathroom and to disturb the Mass. I need your help, and we need to worship properly. If it were only me, I would do like this French priest in the south of France, entering in the procession and locking the door after him. I would do the same with the bathroom. I'm happy you're laughing. It's not on the bulletin, but we have at 4 p.m. Vespers, and also after this Mass, we have the baptism of Daniel Olson, the baby of Mr. and Mrs. Olson. Tomorrow is the Feast of Center of the Child Jesus. We have the relic, and there will be tomorrow a veneration after Mass. Tuesday, St. Francis of Assisi. On Wednesday, St. Placid and his companion. There is a Rosary prayer group at 7 p.m. If you are not in a group, you're invited to come to this group at 7 p.m. Pray your Rosary, have a bit of catechism. It's always good to take, and we really encourage you, especially in this month of October, to be generous with Our Lady of the Masterly Rosary. And first Thursday, it's a day of recollection here. Yeah, there are three Masses, 7:30 a.m., 11 a.m., it's not on the bulletin, but there is a Mass at 11 a.m., and 6 p.m. Friday is first Friday, Mass at 6:30 after the Holy Hour of Reparation, 5:30. As next Saturday, is everything is as usual. First Saturday was yesterday, and we had a beautiful and very fruitful first Saturday of day of Ora et Labora. Good number of people, and I really, really thank all those generous people who came and gave their time. It's a penance. It's a penance, and it's all in the spirit of the first Saturdays. And that way, when you arrive for the meditation and you have the work, there is even catechism, it's perfectly pleasing Our Lady, for sure. You fulfill all our demands coming here on first Saturdays. And thank you for those who came, and we could do a lot. And next Saturday, everything is as usual. There is a Holy Name Society meeting. And we have, after the High Mass, we have at 1 p.m. the Rosary March as usual in October, the closest Sunday to Our Lady of the Masterly Rosary. There is an address from Mr. Jeffrey Ray, our treasurer, to you. Read it carefully. We still need your help, you know that, because for weeks I still ask your help. Some answer, but very few, and they are always the same who answer. And just to tell you that we still need $30,000. It's for all the expenses that we are not scheduled, and especially the furnishing, the priory. We have to rebuild the driveway. There are many details that we knew that had to come, but we didn't really schedule everything, thinking that more generosity will come. It's around $30,000. The works will be finished very quickly. We have the inspection that are coming during the week. And after, I have to finish to pay all the bills. And I want to be able to pay the bills. I have no doubts, but I need your help also. Just for you to measure a few things, I think it's good to know. The missions, it means the people who don't enjoy the proximity of the priory, who cannot have the Mass daily. We cannot have all these spiritual activities, gave between 60% to 70% of the full amount. It means the parish here for the priory project gave between 40% to 30% only. It means there is, I believe, a resource, more resource of generosity here. When you have the Mass daily, you can come daily for Mass, you have the sacraments at hand, easy. But perhaps it's because it's too comfortable and too easy, then you're less generous. It's always like that. It's human. It's very human. The second collection today is for the priest training program. And if you want to give to the, for the building fund, you write building fund. Rosary March, yes, I just have to tell you that it will be at the Downtown Memorial Park, 1 p.m. After this Mass, we have also the cornhole tournament. And we thank all the people who are organizing this tournament. It's a fundraising activity, because not only we have to pay our bills, but there are many things that we are not scheduled that came, medical expenses, etc., the car problems. Just to give you some news from Father Alessio, it was 3 weeks ago, most of you do not know. We had to bring him to the hospital. He stayed for 2 days, and we have to reduce his activities, his apostolate. We should be 4 priests. There is more than enough work for 4 priests. But in all reality today, we are, for all Florida, only 2 priests. We need your help. We need your prayers to be able to continue to face all the apostolate we have to give. And we really need your help, and especially your prayers. It's one of the reasons why we have this holy hour on first Thursday, is to pray for priests. And thank you for this generosity. Finally, the international festival, there is still room if you want to represent your country, bring some food from your country. You just come to Miss Saroya Sade, and she will explain everything. When you see in the bulletin during at 5:30 Rosary, it means always Rosary and Benediction during the month of October. There is Benediction every day. Thank you. In the name of the Father, and the Son, of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Brethren, see how you walk circumspectly, not as unwise, but as wise, redeeming the time, because the days are evil. Wherefore, become not unwise, but understanding what is the will of God. The days are evil. These are the words of Saint Paul. Today is really evil. We are in a world with also its worldly church that are defining our lives in materialistic and corrupt terms. It's all about what I need, all about what I want most, supposedly. Many think the world revolves around us. Ultimately, this exaltation of man is a practical denial of God and of his fatherhood. None of us fundamentally live to ourselves, but to God and to God the Father. St. Paul wrote to the Romans, none of us lives as his own master, and none of us dies as his own master. While we live as the Lord's servants. When we die as the Lord's servants. In life and in death, we belong to the Lord. It's very clear. But in practice, in our days, it's not clear at all. Not clear at all. The good news of our Lord Jesus Christ centers our whole life on the center of the entire universe, God the Father. We live and die in a Father-centered universe because He is the only source of all truth. The Word of God teaches that the most fundamental concern is to desire God our Father, to answer to His love, and to avoid absolutely what cannot please Him: sin. Walk as wise, redeeming the time. Beautiful advice from Saint Paul. Walk as wise, redeeming the time. It's exactly what are the saints, the wise of God, redeeming the time. Man-centered spirit tries to addict us on focusing on having. The devilish powers work constantly to replace the source of peace and joy, which is to be in God the Father, in promoting by any means the desire of having pleasures, having bad company, having deadly pride, having useless possessions. This is the world today. A world of having. So many define themselves in these terms of having, but they are nothing without God. Nothing. It's the month of October. It's a beautiful month. You should rejoice to start this month, to start this month with Our Lady of the Most Holy Rosary, to start this month with the Holy Angels, to start this month with tomorrow the Feast of Saint Therese of the Child Jesus. They all teach the same. They teach us the wisdom of the Gospel, centered on the being of God the Father, source of all beings. Same teaching, same lesson. The Rosary of Our Lady is God, life, and being centered. Obviously, Our Lady focuses on poverty to help us and to allow us to love and to offer our lives to our Father and Creator. The holy angels, they watch over us. Constantly, they watch over us, helping us to remain in God's presence. They see us so often sinning. They see how hypocritical we can be, but their joy is to see us walking circumspectly, not as unwise, but as wise. The teaching of Saint Therese of the Child Jesus is based on the merciful love of God the Father for us. How can we miss this teaching, which is the good news itself? It's the testimony of the popes, so strong. She is the teacher for our times, the great teacher for our times. All her teaching is a teaching of poverty and humility and total trust and confidence in God. St. Pius X wrote, "She is the greatest saint of modern times." Clear, no? If she is the greatest saint of modern times, it's for us. And if you don't know her and our teaching, you have a problem. Because St. Pius X is not the only one. He also wrote to one of the priests who didn't... He was even detracting this teaching of Saint Therese of the Child Jesus. And Saint Pius X answered to this priest, "Her extreme simplicity and poverty is the most extraordinary thing in this soul, unworthy of attention. And he finishes this letter to this priest, go back to your theology. Clear. Benedict XV, the spiritual childhood excludes, in fact, the proud feeling of self. It's all about our times. This man-centered totalitarianism. It excludes the fallacy of sufficing to oneself in the hour of danger and temptation. It supposes living faith in the existence of God and practical homage to his power and mercy. Pius XII, God is the Father whose arms are constantly outstretched to his children. Why not respond to this gesture? Why not cry out without cease to him our immense anguish? We must heed Teresa's words when she invites both the most wretched and the most perfect to let only radical weakness and the spiritual poverty of a sinning creature have effect with God. Now, understand the will of God. Understand the will of God. This is wisdom. This is heavenly wisdom. To know the will of God, to trust the will of God, and to do this will is heavenly wisdom. We need this knowledge, this confidence, this obedience, and this love. And everything depends also on our spirit of poverty. You won't be able to know, to trust, and to love God if you're not poor in spirit. If you don't have this poverty, if you're man-centered, there is no room for God. There is no room for wisdom. Learn the teaching of Saint Therese of the Child Jesus and ask to understand it and to follow it. Pray daily your guardian angel. I know that some people, they never pray their guardian angel. Never! A guardian angel that is constantly taking care of you. Constantly. They never say thank you. Never. Total ignorance. He's always around, ready to help you, to advise you, to guide you. If you have more attention to him, you won't fall. You won't fall. At the very minimum is to pray him in the morning. You say hello. In the evening, you say good night and thank you. It's a very minimum. Very minimum. They are also a great example. They possess nothing. They are spiritual creatures. And they possess nothing. They are all in the Father's due to their perfect poverty and pure being. Now, pray the Rosary, October. And we have many reasons. We have this Rosary Crusade. We have the Rosary Prayer Groups. And we have Our Lady of the Rosary in October. Pray the Rosary. If you pray the Rosary, if you're generous in praying the Rosary, you will always, always seek for the presence of our merciful Father in your life. It will bring you charity and you will give charity. You will spend joyfully time in prayer. You will seek to come at church, to come for Mass even during the week. See, if you don't have this desire of God, this desire of the presence of God in your life, and not only on Sunday, even late, but every day. If you don't have this desire of the presence of God, you have a big problem. And this problem can be fixed by Our Lady and through the prayer of the Rosary. Easily fixed. Start your Rosary, you will see all the blessings, and especially this greatest blessing, which is to desire the presence of Our Lord Jesus Christ in your life, which is a sign of predestination. It's not me who tells that. It's the promise of Our Lady. Promise of Our Lady when you pray your rosary. Praying your rosary is a great sign of predestination. This desire of the presence of Our Lord Jesus Christ in your life, given through the teaching of Saint Therese, through the permanent action of your angel, through the rosary, the prayer of Our Lady, is the only wisdom and the only source of peace and joy. Saint Therese of the Child Jesus, pray for us. Dear holy angels, watch over us. Our Lady of Wisdom, guide us. In the name of the Father, and the Son, of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Thank you.